Crown has not carried out its sentence. I'm sorry, Doctor, but it may become my duty to inform the authorities.
Of what? That the man I was accused of murdering is alive and here by your plan? That I am here also by your plan?
I'm at a crucial point in my work. I need your help. I'll have it, whether you're willing or not.
Yes?
What is it? Voodoo here? Has he brought me a subject? Bring her in.
I suppose you're very proud of yourself, Doctor. You've achieved the complete objectivity of the perfect scientist. People are merely subjects. Notations on a chart have replaced emotions.
This is not true. Perhaps if I show you, you'll understand. Come. Well, Doctor, your diagnosis.
She is alive.
Angelina, age 33, the prime of life, struck down by malignancy of the brain. Angelina Cadman, who's been in a coma now for over 8 months, waiting a cure.
In a coma for 8 months? And you expect a cure?
I won't let her die. She is my wife.
Your what?
You think it's been easy, Dr. Gordon Ramsay, to live with us? To take men and turn them into those things? I who've been knighted by my queen for my achievements in surgery. Doctor, I would put my knife into the brains of 100 men, 1,000, and destroy them all. If I could restore her to me for only one day. I love her. I will not let her get away from me. I will reach out after her down the corridors of eternity, and I'll bring her back. I'll bring her back. Voodoo. You will help me, Dr. Ramsay.
Up by the police, sir. Must have been more than 12 hours.
You idiot, you.
Idiot. Medically very logical, sir. A girl suffers a relapse and Udo becomes an idiot.
Everything was ready. Ready for the culminating operation. Waiting only for you to come with the subject and you bring me a corpse. Your usefulness is over. Very well. You shall substitute. You shall be my next subject.
Me, sir? But... Oh, sir. No. I would never do for this. Wait, you ordered the female subject, sir.
You will have to do.
Why? Why me, sir? Why me, sir, when you already have a female subject right here? All the time right here, she hates you because of Mungo. She's making trouble. Why not use her?
Yes. Daphne, put her on the back sleep. Take her up to surgery at once. What is it? Police? Where are they? In the entrance hall? Outside. Keep them waiting a minute. Then let them in. I'll be there directly. Go. Udo!
outside.
Police?
You mustn't be found here. You must get away directly. You better go through the old monk's kitchen. Here, here's the key.
Sir?
Oh, money, 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 always money.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Sir Gerald Campbell.
At your service.
May I introduce myself? Sergeant Steele, Scotland Yard. Detective Redford, Constable Canoan. Are you acquainted with Udo the Gypsy, the tattoo artist?
I am.
And Miss Carmona Daly?
No, I have not that pleasure.
She dropped from sight after visiting the tattoo parlor of Udo the Gypsy.
We found indications that the Gypsy might have come here.
Yes, he was here. He came to borrow money, but I wouldn't see him. I sent my servant cousin here to get rid of him.
And then you've no idea of his whereabouts or his intentions.
No, I'm sorry. I'd be only too glad to help if I could, Inspector. This fellow Udo is a somewhat malodorous character. He once tried to blackmail me.
Yes, you should see our file on him at the yard. Well, forgive the intrusion at such a late hour, Sir Joel.
Not at all. Good night.
Good night, sir.
Doctor?
It was supposed to be a dual operation.
Yes. I'm going now to help ready the other patients.
No, but... I can't control him.
Mungo, back.
He'll kill Laurie once you're out of the room.
No, he won't. He won't harm her as long as she's under anesthesia. It's only when Laurie talks or moves or looks at him that Mungo goes into a rage.
Thank you. Almighty favors us. Here he hath delivered into our hands and our judgment the Archdeacon of the Wall, Saladin, leader of the Saladin. Kill! Kill! Kill!
Sergeant Steele of Scotland Yard. I would like to question Dr. Cadman further.
I'm afraid you're too late.
Too late? Why? So, Constable Gunnarn, will you take charge here until your coroner comes?
Right you are, sir.
Come along.
What do you think will be my punishment?
The gallows, probably.
Ah. You know, Udo in Gypsy means cat, and cat's got nine lives.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Picture that was, and it's really cool, or not cool, but that was really Bela Lugosi and Basil Rathbone's last film, although Bela Lugosi was quoted as being Plan 9 from Outer Space. We know that was all stock footage and that sort of thing, and I see this monster here is quite the handsome fellow, and I think he's going to work out just quite fine. I have to thank my new assistant over here.
It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure.
Good to see you, thank Soar Johnson.
It's a pleasure to be back.
Very nice. You can see a nice, handsome monster here. Igor, of course, through the technology given Dr. Destruction, can go on and lead a normal life. And maybe he'll do pretty well as Martha Stewart's prison guard. He can help her crochet some nice, I don't know, maybe he can crochet her a nice quilt with a file in it or something, you know, because what she's doing, four counts and five years apiece. But, you know, if that was you or me, we'd probably get about 100 years, but Martha Stewart's lucky if she do 6 months.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You know how that goes. You know, they're cracking down. They got to. You know what I mean? You know, she's out of control over there, you know?
I heard that Martha Stewart and Michael Jackson were starting a wrestling tag team called the Convicts.
Yeah, well, he's about ready for his big verdict as well. Who knows? All we can say is that everyone's got their hands in the pot sooner or later. And I didn't use this hand. You settle down over there. You better give him a shot of the gastrometer. Settle down. Give him a shot. Knock him out. Where's the hypodermic? Where's the comdibliobiator? There you go. There you go. Give it to him there. He looks like he's going to be a problem anyway. I don't. You know what happens with these monsters? They need to be beaten into submission.
Call
you know?
Medicare.
You know, I don't think Medicare is going to cover this one. They ain't going to want to get my bill. There's just no way. Anyway, ghoulies, I hope you had a great time tonight on Crimson Theater. Don't forget the big trolley ride, March 14th at the Trolley Barn, 12 noon. Go to the website, check out the other details. Dorian Gray Art Show coming up, and another very big live appearance on the 27th. But you'll have to go to the address below here, and hopefully that'll be updated, even though it's, of course, under destruction. Great movie tonight. You've got Basil Rathbone, Lon Chaney Jr., Bela Lugosi, John Carradine, you got, if you're watching on Saturday night, you just wait and see what Ralph Pearl got dug up for you for tonight's feature. Give him another shot of that thing. Quick, before he wakes up. I can see this one's going to be a problem. This one's going to definitely be a problem over here. Anyway, ghoulies, all kinds of problems on Crimson Theater as usual. Now settle down. Give him, oh, Jesus.
Oh, I don't know. I think we lost him. He's coming in and out.
Let's leave them out, all right? You know, what do I got to get? Igor back? Anyway, ghoulies, you have a horrifying week, and we'll see you next time on Dr. Destruction's Crimson Theater. Now, go to it. Settle him down.
Wake up.
Thank you. a 1,000 years for this night.
Feed for the dead. Yeah, let me talk to the chief. Yeah, we just found a dead body down at the old Alcard place. Better get some help out here right away.